What's up, brother? Is Sketch, one of Twitch's most beloved creators, recently was exposed for being a ex-OnlyFans creator. And when you look at the situation at hand, it's actually kind of sad to see. How I was brought upon the situation, I had been scrolling through Twitter and I had seen a picture of what seemed to be Sketch. I didn't believe it at first, and then I later on just doing something else, I believe I was editing, and when I went back to Twitter, I then saw multiple sources stating that the said creator that goes by the name of Jamie was proposed to be Sketch.
Oh my god.
Now obviously, when you look at the situation at hand, it was very mind-blowing to say the least. Obviously, if you did not know, the material at hand was between two, the material presented at hand was between two homosexuals who were indeed having intercourse, and I did not believe this at first. It took me by storm. It took the world by storm because it just didn't seem something that, it didn't seem real. It was just too shocking to be like, is that him? Is that not? So basically, when you look at the sources that people were citing, they were showing markings on him and basically fully identifying him based off of his bodily textures. Now today we're going to look at just a few of the reactions that the community had, good and bad. Obviously not everybody's going to be on board with what they, you know, with what their beliefs are. In my personal opinion, I don't care. You can do whatever you want. That does not affect me. It is quite literally none of my business. Now for others, that is not the case. They for some reason feel like it matters, not knowing that people express themselves on a spectrum. But in that regard, we're going to look at other people's reaction to Sketch being exposed. So that being said, take a look. So right here is Sketch's initial reaction to the situation. And he did go on stream and address the situation to confirm that it was him.
Look at this. Open and honest. That was me. That was me. It's okay, though. I will tell you what. Okay. 2 years ago, I did some stuff. I'm sorry if you've seen similar stuff. You know, I'm a changed person. It's going worse than I thought it was. So 2 years ago, I did not have sexual relations with that man. I'm just kidding. I did. Possibly. Cat's out of the bag.
You know, with his attitude about it, it's honestly...
It's okay.
It's honestly good.
What else do I have to say? I don't know. Thank you to all my people that have been sticking up for me. I understand if you're mad. Shit hit the fan. I was dealing with some addiction problems. A couple of them. But.
So as you see, he confirmed it was him. And I kind of like his attitude about it. You know, it's not like he went hiding or anything like that. I liked his attitude about it. You know, he just addressed it straightforward. And quite honestly, like I said again, I don't know why anybody cares of another person's sexual preference. He literally, quite literally, like, it's like some people think that, like, I don't know what they think. It's like, do they think that their relationship with other people is going to affect their livelihood? I don't know. Obviously, not everybody's religiously on the same level. You know, everybody has their beliefs and whatnot. It's out of my way. And, you know, some people, they believe their belief in toes. They're not going to back down. They're not going to give up, as a wise Nikkei 30 once said. But generally, you know, they're not going to change their mindset on what they believe. Some people do. Some people don't. But with that being said, here we have Duke Dennis's reaction to the situation, as he basically says similar thoughts.
Be honest, bro, I don't give a fuck. Y'all shouldn't give a fuck. Right. It's not y'all, you know what I'm saying? Like, if that's not what you into, then that's not, if that's not what you into, then that's, it shouldn't even be that big of a deal.
Exactly.
You know, I think y'all dragging it. And that's even assuming if it's real. If it's real, cool. If it's not, cool. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, he grown. He can do whatever he want to do. I don't know why y'all give a fuck so much. You know, motherfuckers change, bro. Even if it is real, even if that's the past, why y'all bringing up old shit?
Yeah.
If we keep it in the band, why are y'all bringing up old shit? So, whatever his sexual preference is, that don't take away the fact that he's a great fucking guy. I met him. I've been with him. I've been around him. I've been hanging with him. I've been chilling with him. He's a great fucking guy. He's a genuine guy. He's a sweet fucking guy. He's a good dude.
Yeah.
If you stop being his friend just because of that, you weird. I can't care. If you stop being Sketch friend just because of that, if you cut ties, if you don't want to be associated with him just because of that, you weird as hell. And I take it a step further. Y'all, like, this is why the world,
So yeah, Duke Dennis did bring up some good points. Why are they bringing up old shit? I thought that was funny, like how he said it, like, why is y'all bringing up old shit? But yeah, it is weird to feel like you know you're friends with the person. They're still the same person. At the end of the day, you know, it's like somebody being a convicted felon. You know, they're a felon, but if you know felons, they're people who are normal people who are convicted felons. That doesn't mean they're a bad person. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes they bend the rule. Some life ain't fair. Sometimes you got to bend the rule. So, and Sketch isn't like, he's not like an evil person. So it seems, you know, it doesn't seem like he has any bad bone in his body. He just seems very chill, sweet guy. You know, there's not like anything innately wrong with what Sketch does. Besides the fake retard thing, and we can kind of get into that. It is a little weird to pretend to be special ed because, you know, there's people who are special ed and they would not get the same treatment as Sketch does in terms of being able to cognitively think for yourself. Aiden Ross suffered a similar situation when it was, you know, brought up by a YouTuber by the name of Soluminati. He brought up that, you know, Aiden would pretend to be homosexual, but then when, you know, even though he's pretending to do that, there are people who would get made fun of and not be celebrated as they are right now, as much as they would be if they were just heterosexual. But that's a whole nother topic. So next we have XQC's reaction to the thing, which I think he brings up a very good analogy and a good point to the situation. So let's see it.
You wanna go out and get fucked up? Get fucked up. I don't actually give a fuck. Do your thing. Because I'm doing my thing. I'm not gonna pretend like I don't do my thing. I do my thing.
Right.
Do your thing.
Right.
Stop policing anybody like you care. You don't. So why you act like you care when somebody being gay or somebody kissing a dude or somebody gambling or somebody being trans? Protect my children. If you cared about protecting children, you wouldn't do 80% of the shit you do on a daily basis on your stream. You don't care.
Right.
And that's fine. I don't care either. Just stop pretending.
Holy shit, man.
Passion.
How hard is that?
Now, X did bring up a good point. It's like, you do your thing. I do my thing. People do their thing. Whatever they like. You know, you don't have to attack somebody for it. What they like. I've never got that thought process. Some people, and we know who we're talking about. Oh, we know who we're talking about. Just don't like it. And they see it as a bad thing. But now that being said, I'm kind of interested to see where Sketch takes his career next or what he ends up doing now. Hopefully he does something great to, you know, be for the greater good and, you know, not think about this as a bad thing, even though people are going to try to make it because some people live pessimistically for the love of it. Right here is Kai's reaction to the situation and what occurred and his thought process on it.
I understand that a lot, it may be shocking to a lot of people, but bro, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, that's how it was for me, which is very shocking.
Nigga, and shit is crazy. You feel me? Like, I seen that he said it was like his past and shit, and whether it was or not, bro, I'm not gonna lie, this is how I view the situation. You feel what I'm saying? Why does something that somebody else do get you so mad to the point where you gotta go on the internet and bully the nigga, like, and say crazy shit? You would think that this nigga murdered somebody, like,
right.
Bro, like, you feel me? Like, you would think the nigga murdered somebody by the way niggas is talking, bro. And it's like, bro, what the fuck? Like, Chad, this is the thing, bro. Like, me personally, I'm not in no place to judge anybody for what they do or what they have done. You feel me? That's not me.
Yeah.
Not my body, bro. I can't do that. Wanna know why? Because I'm human, nigga. Right. I'm human. We are human, nigga. Exactly. Like, nigga, we are not perfect.
Right. He brings up a perfect example. You know, we're human. We are quite literally, not to get too, you know, philosophical, but like, bro, we just on the earth. You know what I'm saying? We just vibing on the earth. We doing whatever the fuck. We you know, whatever makes us comfortable, makes us happy. That's what we doing on the earth. And it brings up a great point. You know, it just was shocking. Like, I think even if it wasn't, you know, homosexual activities or intercourse happening, even if it was just like, you know what I'm saying? I feel like it would just be shocking regardless. It's just the fact that it happened. I don't even think it's in regards to, for some people it is that factor. For me, it just was shocking because he was an OF star, basically. I mean, that's pretty shocking, no? Even if he, you know, was hitting, flipping Sabrina Carpenter, bro. That would be even crazier. Like, imagine, like, how crazy that would be. But yeah, bro, you know, I just want to see where he, you know, resides now, what he does in the future. I think he can do great, you know, maybe some charitable work. And I like that he never puts it onto his viewers. None of his viewers, or, you know, he never pushed any of that sort of sex work or any of that regard, never promoting OF stars or anything like that to his community. So that's something that, you know, was thought that was something that, you know, was he should be I'm not gonna say celebrated for, but I feel like it's a good deed, because, you know, there are some people who don't even do OnlyFans and still promote OnlyFans content. Not gonna name any names, but yeah, bro, I'm excited to see what Sketch does in the future. He's a chill guy. I don't watch Sketch. Now, with his, like, retarded shtick, I think he should drop that shit, honestly. Like, we know you're not retarded. I mean, he's probably going to keep doing it because, you know, that's his shtick and that's his thing. But I never really found it funny. And that's just my personal preference, you know? It's just my personal preference. I never really found it funny. I never really watched Sketch. Just not my streamer, you know? Not my forte or streaming entertainment. But you know what? With that being said, that's going to wrap us up for today. Just want to kind of talk about the situation. I wasn't even going to make this video. I quite literally did not want to make this video. But I'm, you know, I'm leaving it at that. You know, we leave it at this. And Sketch, if you watch this, never back down, never give up. And with that being said, I'll see you when you're old. Peace. Roller coaster.